Welcome to my weekly space news segment called Supermassive News. Here, I'll go over space news from the space industry and scientific discoveries that cover all things space. Whether it be international space policy, scientific discovery, or when Elon Musk finally makes it to Mars, you can expect these every Saturday. So let's dive in. Last week, China successfully launched 3 humans to their orbiting space station. Now, this is really, really important because in the past, America has excluded China from participating in the International Space Station. Now, these are for reasons of distrust, which we'll go over in a later episode, but it's really, really important because China has now solidified itself as a major player in space exploration. They've delivered a rover successfully to Mars, and now humans are orbiting in their own space station. China is now a country we need to look out for as they partner with Russia to beat us to the moon in building a lunar base. Next, NASA has now changed the radiation exposure limits for humans traveling beyond Earth. Now, it used to be 130 millisieverts of radiation for a 30-year-old human, and 700 millisieverts of radiation for a 65-year-old human. And that was based on the amount of radiation it would take to raise their chances of dying to radiation exposure by 3%. But now they've changed it to 600 millisieverts across the board. This is the average amount of exposure that a 35-year-old female would experience that would raise her chance of dying from radiation exposure by 3%. So now it's 600 millisieverts across the board. This is still not enough radiation exposure to allow humans to go to Mars, so we're still gonna have to develop some kind of technology to further protect ourselves. So NASA is not sending humans to Mars anytime soon. Virgin Galactic has been cleared to fly customers on their spaceship too. Scientists have now found more evidence of tectonic activity on Venus, and they claim that the surface is more like floating ice sheets on an ocean. Space Perspective, the company that's planning to offer stratospheric balloon rides to paying tourists, has formally opened ticket sales after their first successful test flight. It's going to cost $125,000 per person. And the Hubble Space Telescope is still offline due to troubles with its memory system and its computer, and it's been offline since June 13th, so I'll keep you updated on that. And that was Supermassive News for Saturday, June 26th. Don't forget to subscribe so you're alerted when new episodes come out, and I'll see you guys next week.